Hudson Bridge northbound looks good as well, but now we have slowdowns on the southbound side of Henry Hudson Parkway coming on down towards 125th Street, out towards 96th Street, where it's word of construction. And probably go traffic farther down, 79th Street on down towards 57th on West Side Highway. Here's what you need to know about bridges and tunnels inbound at the Holland Tunnel. We're at about 20-25 minutes outbound, about 20. It's coming up on 30 minutes for the inbound Lincoln, about 15-20 outbound. It's about a half hour into the upper and lower levels of the GWB. The outbound side coming from the Cross Bronx, that'll be about 30-35 minutes. Also, we're tied up on the southbound side of the Van Wyck, coming from the Grand Central down towards Jamaica Avenue. That's the site of a crash blocking one lane. Our next update is at 12:51 on 1010 Wind.
A $220 billion budget deal is headed to the desk of New York State Governor Kathy Hochul. State Senate and Assembly worked into the wee small hours of the morning Friday to get bills passed. The governor says she'll sign the legislation. Among the items in the budget, tax breaks for homeowners, drivers, and cannabis businesses. And the budget also includes some items meant to address rising crime, including granting judges more discretion in setting bail, amending gun charges, and giving prosecutors more leeway when handing over evidence. Mayor Adams spoke to our Rich Quinn early in the day Friday on Newsline.
Well, I want to thank the governor for being a partner and understanding that we must have a safe city. I say this over and over again. The prerequisite to our prosperity is public safety and justice. I think the governor is a partner in that, and I'm going to continue to partner with her.
The budget will include some much-needed relief at the gas pump for New Yorkers. It's a suspension of part of the state's gas tax from June 1st through the rest of the year. An overnight shooting in the Crown Heights section of Brooklyn.
The detectives have been out combing the neighborhood and doing interviews, but they don't have too much to work with. The two men who were shot have no known criminal history themselves. The police say they were in the lobby of 1144 Bergen Street when a man outside the lobby fired at them. Xavier lives down the block and is upset.
It's sad because I have a son myself, so I'm always paranoid when he's outside of the house. You never know what's going to happen, so I hate to hear this.
And Andrew believes he knows how to fix the violence.
We protect ourselves by strengthening our communities and defunding the police.
The motive for the shooting is unknown. Carol DiIuri, 1010 Winds on Bergen Street in Brooklyn.
NYPD has announced arrests in last Monday's fatal shooting of a 61-year-old woman, Bronx woman. Juana Esperanza Soriano de Perdomo was hit by a stray bullet Monday night when two groups started firing at each other at 188th Street off the Grand Concourse in the Bronx. Under arrest, 20-year-old Donald Johnson, 33-year-old Raquel Hampton. Police Commissioner Keyshawn Sewell says both suspects have lengthy criminal histories. The murder of Soriano de Perdomo came less than a week after the stray bullet killing of 12-year-old Cade Lewin in Brooklyn. Commissioner Sewell called Soriano de Perdomo's killing, quote, another example of pointless violence on the streets of our city. With News Time 12:45, word today that NFL quarterback Dwayne Haskins has been killed in a car accident in South Florida. ESPN is reporting that it happened this morning. Haskins played at Ohio State, finished third in the Heisman Trophy voting in 2018, and was a first-round draft pick by the Washington football team. He was on the Pittsburgh Steelers this past season, though he didn't play. Dwayne Haskins was 24. Jake, taking a look at AccuWeather. Breezy and cool this afternoon. A shower at times. Perhaps some breaks of sun. Any shower could bruise a quick downpour. Small hail and a rumble of thunder. And we'll get up to a high of 57. We're 51 right now. Tonight, partly cloudy. Low 41. Mid-30s across some of the suburbs. So a pretty cool night. Tomorrow, clouds and some sun with a chilly breeze. Perhaps a shower in the area. High of 52. Then Monday, early sun gives way to some clouds. A bit milder. High 58. Can't rule out a shower. Monday night and Tuesday, much warmer, with sunshine and some clouds and a high of 72. Wins News Time, 12:46. A fatal shooting yesterday outside of Bronx High School. Police say a 16-year-old girl was killed when shooting erupted outside of the University Heights High School's South Bronx campus just after 1:30 yesterday afternoon. Police say the shooter was arguing with someone across the street and then fired off six shots. Authorities say 16-year-old Angel Yambo was killed in the gunfire. Two other students were wounded. Police say none of the victims were the intended targets of the shooting. Wins News Time, 12:47. Now to the latest on COVID, with more and more word about the spread of the BA2 variant. Word out of Washington is that at least 53 people at the annual Gridiron Club dinner last Saturday have tested positive. That dinner attracts some 700 guests. There's word of other positive tests, COVID tests that are rattling the nation.
testing positive, among others, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi, Senator Susan Collins. President Biden kissed Speaker Pelosi on the cheek before her diagnosis, then tested negative Friday morning. Vice President Harris, who came in close contact with her communications director, who is positive, tested negative Thursday and then again on Friday when she presided over the Judge Jackson vote without a mask. Her office says her doctor told her that would be okay.
This correspondent Phil Lipoff, weekly COVID update from New Jersey includes 53 new confirmed deaths. New York State latest numbers indicate a 7-day positivity rate of 3.55%. When's news time? 12:48. Not sure if space is the final frontier, but it is increasingly the frontier of civilians, rather well-heeled civilians. The Axiom Mission 1 crew arrived at the International Space Station this morning. First of its kind. Private charter, passenger flight to the International Space Station.
They paid $55 million to spend 10 days in space, but their tickets don't guarantee them access to the Russian space station or the part where the Russians are. They'll need permission from the three cosmonauts on board for that one. And the four passengers are expected to return to Earth 10 days from now, splashing down off the coast of Florida.